you guys are doing, Arrowverse here. Now, if you do me a favor, hit that like and subscribe button and push that bell for notifications all. Now, I want to apologize ahead of time for this because sometimes if you hear my voice a little ratchet, it's because I'm on VoiceCoin and I'm uploading demo samples of an interesting voice I could do because I'm becoming a voice actor for a video game. I get a few casting calls basically. So I could upload 30 of them. Other than that, basically let's do a recap video of Legends of Tomorrow. So let's dive right into it, I believe. So at first, Basher believes that the Legends know about his birthday, which they don't exactly, they forgot about it. Well, technically they don't, his sister should know about his birthday. Other than that, they're trying to find this alien sighting that is actually on a film movie set. They're trying to look for it, exactly its location. Meanwhile, Mick gets a voice, I guess you could say a FaceTime, yes. I guess he has an iPhone, probably like an iPhone X, maybe, I don't know. So she has some big news for him, his daughter, and he steals Ava's time watch, and he teleports his daughter onto the Wave Rider, and the big news is that she's pregnant and he's going to be a grandfather, basically. He does not take the news too well and she storms off on the Wave Rider, and Ava and Mick are trying to find his daughter. Back in Vancouver, 2023, wow, that's 2 years from now. His movie set film, Bayard actually sees that it's his favorite TV show that they're filming there. He believes that the Legends remember his birthday and they took him there because it's his birthday, but the Legends are like, yeah, we kind of forgot about it, so let's just play along, basically. And so Sarah takes, let's just say Bat Spooner so that they can look for the ship before it even lands. But the thing is that, they found the ship right in the air. But Spooner had to take out her modified pistol and shoot the damn ship down, and let's just say that we all already know where it landed at. Now Astra and Zari are not having the time of their lives inside the audience watching the show, but Bayard is, and the audience, they're not really enjoying the show either. They're not liking it, clapping nor laughing, except over Bayard. The director sees it and he knows that his show is dying and he needs his show to be more interesting. So then boosh, the alien crashes right through the movie set. Let's just say that the audience are thrilled about that, and yes, the Legends are shocked. They're like, I think our job is done trying to look for the alien right now. So they finally see the alien, and Bayard says that you guys forgot about my birthday, and this is not about my birthday, it's another mission, isn't it, basically. Well, the director tells his co-host, well, that's actually his brother, that we're going to add this alien onto our set, onto the film set, the TV show. Zari films it so that they could go back and talk to Gary about it. Well, Sarah and Spooner finally found out what the mess they made and basically where the alien landed at. They finally found Mick's daughter, and let's just say that Mick opens up to his daughter and he wants to know more about her boyfriend, Nico, basically. Astra and Bayard pose as a PA, trying to look for the alien, but they can't find him anymore, but they finally do find him. So they all rush back to the Wave Rider to recoup and to get a plan down. So they talk to Gary and show Gary what kind of alien it is, and Gary says that, well, technically, I don't know how to pronounce what Gary said the alien is, but they call it Gus Gus. So we'll just say it's Gus Gus. Meanwhile, the script has changed, and basically, that means Bayard has changed. Well, I mean, Bayard has changed his look, his attitude, and his personality, basically. So Zari and Nate need to crash the, I guess you could say, cast inside the film TV show, but Zari does not get the, casting role, but Nate does, surprisingly. Wow. Other than that's, I guess you could say Mick's daughter tells Ava and Sarah what happens and what they talk about her and her father. Mick, he wanted to talk about Nico, her boyfriend, the reason why it's 'cause he's going to kill him. And so they definitely need to find out where Mick is at. Meanwhile, Bayard is a full cocky douchebag at the moment right now. They need to get him back to normal. And they finally found Mick, Ava, his daughter, and Gary. He's actually having a heart-to-heart conversation with her boyfriend, and he's thanking her, and he says that make sure you treat her well, basically. There's a lot to it I want to explain in depth, but I can't really. So Zari takes her brother, locks him up inside the Wave Rider, says, "You're staying here until we fix this script, until you get back to normal," basically. That's why she locked her brother up. So meanwhile, as soon as Nate is on the show, he crashes the show, interrupts the show, does not say his lines at all. He does take the alien away, and one of the co-hosts, stars of the show, actually helps him out, get the alien out of the way. The audience loves it, the director loves it, and finally, the legends have the alien now. They need to take the alien right off this film set so that they could go back on the Wave Rider. So everyone's happy, everyone's thrilled about that. So Bayard, he's back to normal, back to his old self, basically. So they have a little birthday party for him, and let's just say that something big actually happens. Z and Zari actually talk inside the totem, and Z tells Zari that, well, you could come outside the totem. Reason why is because only one of us has to stay inside. And so she gave Zari, well, Z, the time of her life, saying that you have 2 weeks out there, she'll give her. And Nate is really happy about that, I guess you could say. Other than that, well, let's just say that they gave Zari the 411 about what happened in the past a few months, basically. Other than that, I hope you guys enjoyed this logo I created. It took me an hour to make. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video as well. If you're new, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you all in the next video.